हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अनिकेत कर्ष एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ वैल्यू एजुकेशन. देन दिस ऑल आर टॉपिक्स वी विल कवर. सो फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज ह्यूमिलिटी, राइट? सो लेट्स सी ह्यूमिलिटी. अ जिराफ एंड अ गोट वर टू फ्रेंड्स. वन डे दे हैड एन आर्ग्यूमेंट. द जिराफ सेड टू द गोट, I am tall and nothing is better than being tall. The goat replied, I am short and nothing is being better than short. On hearing this, the giraffe laughed and said, if you can prove that what you say, I will give up my tail. Okay. On hearing this, the goat also said, if I fail to prove what I say, I will give up my snout. They both agreed and started walking together. They reached a garden, which was enclosed by a low wall and did not have any entry gate. The giraffe stood outside the garden and readily plucked the leaves from the tall branches of the trees with the help of his long neck. Okay, what he plucked, what it you know giraffe plucked the leaves from the tall branches of the trees, okay, and starting eating them. Then he turned towards the goat and asked, now what would you like to be, tall or short? The goat didn't say anything. They continued walking and came to another garden enclosed by a high wall. As they walked around it, the goat saw an edge of garden which was fenced with the bamboo sticks. The goat and the giraffe tried hard to make their way through it. The bamboo sticks were bound so firmly that the giraffe could not push them to make his way. The goat, on the other hand, found a small weak spot at the bottom, broke it and made her way. She entered the garden and ate all the vegetables she could. She relished the vegetables and ate until she was satisfied. She entered the garden and ate all the vegetables she could. She relished the vegetables and ate until she was satisfied. She came out and looked at the giraffe, who stood outside, because he was too tall to enter the garden. The giraffe, whose mouth was watering at the sight of all the fresh vegetables, looked at the goat sadly. The goat then asked him, now, what would you like to be, tall or short? So, as you can see, the giraffe was unable to enter due to the bamboo bound fencing, and this goat can easily enter from the some kind of weak point at the bottom of that fencing, and the giraffe at the other end on that point where the leaves from the tree he can easily pluck, which goat cannot. So there's a advantages and disadvantages both in case of tall also and short also. So whatever God has given us, we should be satisfied. We should satisfy ourselves, because whatever God has given to us is enough, right? Whatever we deserve, we have, right? The giraffe was speechless. He could not reply and hung his head in shame. Thus the goat taught the giraffe a lesson of humility. Everyone is unique in his own way, right? The moral of the story is, everyone is unique in his own way. Okay? So, humility, you learned, right? Humble. We should be humble to everybody. So now let's see what all questions are given in the multiple choice questions. What lessons did the goat teach giraffe? Right, obviously humility, because the giraffe was thinking that being tall is, you know, is a great thing, and as a goat is a small, you know, so he cannot do anything. He's not having that much capability as giraffe is having, right? So the goat teach the quality of humility to giraffe. Second, so the answer of the first one is humility. Okay, humility. Now, wait. So four questions are there. So here, humility. Okay, a giraffe and a goat were friends, enemies, relatives, none of this. Obviously, friends we have seen in the chapter. What would the giraffe give up according to the challenge? Giraffe tails. Okay, what giraffe told that he will give up his tail if he will, you know, if goat will prove him wrong. Okay, now after breaking the bamboo sticks of the fence, what did the goat start eating? Goats start eating vegetables, right? Vegetables. Okay, this is the answer. Vegetables. Now next. True and false. So, a goat taught a very good lesson of humility to the giraffe. Yes, it's true. We have seen. I shall give up my snout, the goat said. Yes, this is true. What the goat said? When she will, you know, fail to prove herself, then she will give up her snout. Okay. The giraffe is short like a goat. No, this is false. The giraffe is not short. It is too tall, very tall, right? The goat ate leaves of the trees and the giraffe ate vegetables. This is also false. Opposite of whatever happened. The goat ate leaves of the trees. No, giraffe ate the leaves of the trees. And vegetables were ate by goat. Okay. So, true, false. Now, next. Answer the following questions. So, what is the moral of the story? Everyone is unique in his own way. Everyone is unique in his her own ways, right? Because whatever you have one quality in yourself, right? Whatever quality you have, you know, you are unique. Whatever you do, you know, you have something means, okay? Don't underestimate or don't understand and underestimate others, right? All are equal, so everyone is unique in his her own ways, right? Do you appreciate the talent of other people or do you consider yourself superior to others? Tell me, do you appreciate the talents of others, people? Do you appreciate the talent of your friends? We should always, right? We should always appreciate, right? Or do you consider yourself superior to others? No, we should not. We should be confident, but we should not, you know, consider ourselves superior, because if you are good in dancing, then other one may be good in singing, right? So all are equal. Getting? All are equal. All are having some unique qualities, right? What happened at the garden enclosed by the high wall? In what happened in the case of high wall? The goat, you know, giraffe was unable to enter due to, you know, bounding of that bamboo fencing. But the, you know, goat entered from the, you know, she spotted the weak point at the bottom and she entered from there. And giraffe was standing outside. And goat entered and started eating vegetables, right? So that happened at the garden enclosed by high walls, right? Now, this three we have completed. Now fourth, what was the challenge between the goat and the giraffe? That who is better? The challenge was who is better? the giraffe who is very tall, or the goat who is short, right? Who is better? They wanted to prove each other that the to having a short, you know, tall height is better, or a short height. They challenged each other. Okay, what do you understand by humility? Humility means means we should be humble. We should not underestimate anybody, or we should not show anybody that you are nothing like that. Okay, all are equal. Means if you have even if you have any quality, then even if you are not being proud, okay, because you are also aware of your bad qualities. If you are having good, if you are having something good, then also something bad. If you are good in strong in something, then some weak point is also there in you, right? Everybody is made up of, you know, both good as well as bad, strong as well as weak, like that. So humility means we should be humble. Our behavior should be humble to everybody, and we should you know, not underestimate, or you know, because everybody is unique in his or her quality. Yes. What was the argument between the goat and the giraffe? What was the argument between the goat and the giraffe? That who is better, right? Who is better, the tall one or the short one? That was the argument between. The most you know, the answer of this question. And do you appreciate the challenge? What happened? What was the challenge between the goat and? The answer of both these questions are similar kind. Okay, so I will send you the PDF also of this. And next, is it over or anything left? Let's see. Okay, one more thing is there. Okay. Fill in the blanks with the correct words in the given box. A giraffe and a goat were having an obviously argument. Okay, so first one is this argument. Okay, now next. Wait a minute. Here I am writing, so it will be more clear. Now, the bamboo sticks were very firmly bound for the dash to make his way from boundly. So who was you know, not able to enter, you know, giraffe. It was very, you know, firm or tight, so that giraffe can, because giraffe was very tall, you know, giraffe. So here second giraffe will come. Okay, the goat taught giraffe a good lesson of humility. Lesson of humility. So humility, third one will be come here. Now next, they continued dash and came to the garden enclosed by high walls. So here four. Wow, they continued walking. After challenging each other, they continued walking. So this all right. Okay, now maintain one small notebook also, right? Maintain one small notebook also. Now next, make a group of four and write a short story on humility. Paste and draw pictures, good titles, discuss with your teacher and classmate. Make a group of four. Okay, this is right now, this is write a short story on humility. Paste, draw pictures, good titles, discuss with your teacher and classmate. So you can write, you know, you can do this activity. You can write one small story on humility, very small story, one paragraph only, in your notebook. Okay, now write five antonyms and synonyms of humility. Humility, right? Antonyms and five synonyms of humility. So maintain, write five you know, antonyms and synonyms of humility. Four synonym and antonym, right? Teach the students that every person has his own speciality and importance. We should humiliate and understand everyone. Okay. So, we have done this, right? We have completed this first chapter. You can find it, you can solve this, find five antonym and five synonym from the dictionary, or you can from the Google. You can humility synonym. Synonym and a similar kind of meaning. Antonym is opposite of that humility, which is not good. Okay, humble is a synonym of humility, like this. So that's it. Thank you. Have a nice day.